Yeah,
so how you producer, man? Tell us how you met your producer, man, how they putting your music in, you know what I'm saying, and how you feel about all that.
Yeah, my producer, his name's Jay Green, and I met him back in 2004 at college, actually. And, yeah, it was actually funny. We're on the elevator one day at school, and I didn't know him or nothing, but I overheard him talking to some girl about it. He just helped some other dude put out a mixtape or something like that. So, like, when the opportunity presented itself, I didn't really knock on the door. I sort of kicked it down. And I, like, because I had just started writing music, and I was trying to find some place. So I was recording on my karaoke machine in my bedroom. So I was, like, obviously trying to find some place where I could, like, actually record professionally.
Right.
So I asked him who he was and everything. He handed me a business card, and the rest is history. 2 weeks later, I was in the studio. And, you know, we get along great. We've known each other since 2004, we never even raised our voices at each other once. You know what I mean? So it's like,
that's real,
you know. So he's a good dude. He's a hard worker, and that's pretty much why I get along with him. You know, he knows what he's doing. He's on top of his game.
No question, baby. All right, I got a question for you, man. What was the first project that you did? And after you finished with your project, you said to yourself, "Now I'm on my way. This is what I'm talking about." And I'm not talking about your current. I'm saying at some point, you know what I'm saying, you had to kind of do something and heard yourself and said, "Yo, I can really, really do this, baby. And I'm getting ready to make a lot of paper from doing this." Even though paper has nothing to do with it, but you enjoyed what you was doing.
Yeah. I think it definitely wasn't my first one. I came out with a mixtape back in 2006.
Okay.
And it was good for the time and everything. It's completely different from what I do now. And then I came out with my first full length album in 2010, and then I had an EP edited version of that same album, and then last year I got signed to a little label in Oklahoma called Tate.
Okay.
And they re-released the 2010 album, and I think that was the one because it was distributed through a small label and everything.
Right.
That was the one that I said, okay, and I had a release party for it and everything, and the whole thing was just real successful. And I was like, all right, I was like, that was when I knew something is obviously going to happen here. And that was also the point when I realized that I was in so far that there was pretty much no going back. So I had, you know, I was at the point where in my mind I had no choice. Like, I had to keep on going.
No question.
So I think that was probably the release, the one just last year that I said to myself, all right, I said, now, I was like, I think I'm on my way.
Yeah, no doubt. All right, baby, let's get to the current project that you're working on. You know what I'm saying? Let everybody know, man, what the single is, what the songs are, what the album is. You know what I'm saying? What it took for you to put it down. What was your inspiration for making this the way you made it? You know what I mean? Come on, let us know what it is, baby.
Yeah, the first single is called Like That, and it's a pretty hot club track. We're getting ready to release it pretty soon. In May, I believe, we're going to be releasing that record. Then the follow-up is Lose Your Mind.
Mm-hmm.
Videos are coming for both of them. And pretty much right now, man, like, I'm hustling. I'm in the studio. I'm getting new material. I'm calling my people, making sure everybody's on point for the video and all that different stuff. And the video shoot is going to be April 25th. And then we're going to be releasing it soon after that,
right.
for Like That. And then, like I said, after that, it's going to be Lose Your Mind. It's going to be hopefully the follow-up. And, then we're looking at probably a full-length album, hopefully sometime around September, possibly a little later. But pretty much that's where we're at right now, is we're just putting the final prep on everything to get the release going.
Right. Now, I got, you know, like I said, I've been around a little bit. I've seen a lot of different artists, like I said, come and go. I've seen a lot of things, man, incredible things happen within this game. And I'm curious to know, man, was it a hard transition for you to go from basically being a lyricist to actually now putting out basically some EDM music? You know what I'm saying? Tell us how that transition took place, man, and how you really feel about all that, man. Is it how it actually makes you feel good about what you're doing?
Yeah, I like what I do. Music, like, again, is something that I've been listening to, obviously, since I was a little kid. And I think the transition from lyricist to doing the club stuff really wasn't that hard, because I had to go backwards, because I was putting, you know, a lot of time in with the writing and everything. And the club music is a lot more, you can vibe to it a lot more. So it's a little bit easier for me to clinch, actually. Some people would disagree with that. But going from lyricism and, like, a lot of complex and compound rhyme schemes and things like that to just your basic club music that people can vibe to, for me was a pretty easy transition. Didn't really take too long to do. And it's fun. Like, I'm having fun with it again. You know, sometimes it was getting to the point where it wasn't fun anymore.
Right.
And I always said, if you like what you're doing, you'll never work a day in your life. And mm-hmm. this is what I love to do. So I consider myself lucky. And I mean, I worked hard for it, but I consider myself lucky that I'm one of the ones that's going to be able to do what he wants to do.
No question, baby. And now, a lot of people don't know, man, you kind of find out, man, you're a pretty socially conscious artist, you know what I'm saying? And I want you to let everybody know some of the different things that you're out there doing and some of the different things that you're out there supporting, man. You know what I'm saying? Because I think that's a real plus, man, for the things that you're doing, man, and the platform that you hold. You heard?
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, well, we actually just got done doing a benefit for a couple of families who had cancer victims, and it was pretty successful. It was just last Friday. Everybody had a great time. We raised some money for the families, and I think, you know, we got sponsors for it and everything. And not only did we get sponsors, but we got local sponsors. We had a couple of bigger ones, like Glen Peter Diamond Center, but we had a couple, like my buddy's restaurant, Lorenzo's Cafe, and a couple other places. Vent Fitness also, it's a gym here in upstate New York. They all sponsored it. They all gave donations. So it just shows you that when you're doing something for the community is also going to want to get involved. You know, and that was pretty much that's what we do. Like me and the dude that I do it with, that I did that with, his name's Tony. We Rise and Fly, and he pretty much brought it to my attention about these two families. And that's when I looked at him and was like, we should do something about it then. So not only, I don't want to just do this just for me. Like, I always remember my roots. I remember where I come from. I remember the people that support me. And I love each and every one of them. You know what I mean? And that's what it's all about. In the end, I want to be able to give back. And that's what I'm about.
That's a beautiful thing, man. Listen, I got one more question, baby. When it's all said and done, and they speak on Luco Brasi, whether it be 5 years, 10 years, 20 years, what you want to be said about the things that Luco Brasi did in his career?
Enlightenment. If I could wrap it up into one word, I think it would be enlightenment. I want to bring knowledge. I want to bring awareness, not only to music. You know, I think I said something a while back. I said, what's wrong with music partially right now is people are more interested in the money than the meaning mm-hmm. behind it.
No doubt.
And I think that if you can make a living off it, I think that's great. But you know something? I think no matter what kind of music you do, whether it's club, rap, lyricism, rock, it doesn't matter. You should try to bring enlightenment and more knowledge to people. So if I want to be remembered as somebody who was, first of all, passionate about what he does, loves his family, loves the community, and is able to enlighten people and make people aware of what's going on. And you know, if you see someone in need, you do what you can to help them.
No question, baby. No doubt about that. For all my listeners out there, baby, y'all got to hear first right here on Mafia Magazine Radio, man. And we talking to my man, Luco Brasi. Hey, Luco, man, but check it, baby. Look, I should say, before we go, man, I want to give you another opportunity, man, to shout out and plug everything and everybody that's helped you get to the place to where you are today.
All right, no doubt. Yeah, if you want to see me, it's www.lucobrasi.com or facebook.com/LucoBrasiFan. Want to give a big shout out right now, definitely my parents and my grandmother, all my friends, Jay Green Money Talks, Robert Sorrell, Jamie O, my girl Nina, Sarah, Jenny, all you guys, you know I love you, and thank you all for standing by me. I appreciate it.
No doubt, baby. And y'all make sure y'all stay locked in, baby, because we're going to bang them tracks that Luco was just talking about, man. Hey, Luco, baby, let me just say this to you, man. Listen, man, may you always be blessed in everything that you do, man, and may you prosper in all that you do. You all right?
All right. Thank you, man. I appreciate it.
No doubt, baby. Peace.
Later.